Hello everyone, here is my commentary on the new difficulty just introduced to DDO, which is repair. And but I haven't tried it on Lamagna, so my experience with it is kind of short. Just did some quests last night. Which sadly I recorded just half of, of those. First I had recorded Bringing the Light on Reaper 1, 3 and 5 on my level 7 artificer, which you can see here playing. And after that I went into the depths of Discord and then Doom, which are at level on Reaper 1 and quite easily completed actually, and tried also Chamber of Insanity in LSK, all on Reaper 1. You will see this video also as a part of the a whole life project, because well, this is at level. While Bringing the Light failed to record, sadly. I started to give the a commentary on what I understood from Bringing the Light, which is a level 2 quest, so I was almost at cap for running it on Reaper. Well, Reaper 1 was pretty easy. I think there were no Reaper at all, maybe one. So I said, oh well, this is easy. Should be noted, being a level 2 quest make champion not appear, because champions don't appear on quests that are level less than 5. So level 2 quests on Elite are level 4, and therefore they have no champion. That's maybe the reason it was so easy to do. And also being level 7 helped, since I used a lot higher level cure, I mean repair, and higher level hiring and so on. Then I went into Reaper 3, and it was not easy. I could complete, but in one of the two rooms I found two Reapers, one of which gave some sort of AoE dot of for force energy damage over time, and it was pretty tough. One of the hirelings died, the highest level one, which is kinda funny, and but I was able to pull it. Should be noted, I was able only because I had Die Hard, being a Warforged, and I have an Ivy. I had an Ivy because he healed me when I was at minus 9 hit points and saved me that way. Well, completed. So after that, I went on to Reaper 5 and I failed. I failed thanks to a reaper in combination with a boss. Those were pretty tough and should not be, I wasn't able to complete. Fun fact, the first two rooms were easier than Reaper 3 because I didn't find two Reapers. That's it. The actual difficulty of a quest depends on random, whether or not you find multiple Reapers. After this experience, I said, what the hell, let's just go at level Reaper 1. And I pulled it. I had a party member starting after some time, as you can see on the video. But still was doable. I mean, yeah, champion, especially Red Crown, were scary. Reapers were scary, especially those that gives you fear itself, which is, as a matter of fact, a force DOT, and I think it's also an area effect DOT, which is pretty tough to beat. Reapers spawn have a percentage of spawning depending on how many mobs there are. So in a situation where you get a big dungeon alert, you know there will be Reapers inside of that mob. Example, you will see, or maybe you already saw, I wasn't paying attention on the video, is large violet smiles which break into a lot of low CR slimes and which give immediate red alert. And every time that happened, there were at least one Reaper, if not two. Those slimes have 50 hit points, maybe, die in a single lightning sphere, but yeah, Reapers are there, and Reapers are scary. So what do you need to complete Reaper? Well, first of all, I suggest you to, at least for Heroic, just going on Reaper 1. You will get anything you want. You get the 120% bonus to XP compared to the 80 from Elite for the first time completion. And you get some Reaper XP. So someday, thanks to the Reaper 3, they were the easier. It's a long grind, but it's not like you have to get to that. It's just you get it. You don't care about it, but you get it. And you just keep going. One thing that you must have is Ghost Touch or Ghostly. I mean, if you're not a pure spellcaster, because Reapers are incorporeal. And if you see, especially, you see, this turn is rangy. You see a Reaper far, far, far away, and 50% of your hits miss due to incorporeality, because Reapers are incorporeal. That was not funny. I mean, as an RT, I was able to use a spell, but if you're pure melee, For instance, you need to be able to kill it fast. Reapers don't seem to have higher hit points, but they do pretty significant damage and or debuffs. So be sure to hit them fast. What else? Well, that's basically all there's to say. And Reapers can spawn in the walls behind the secret door, and most of them has some area of effect debuff or damage or something, and they get through the wall. They seem also to be able to get through the wall. One in bringing the light spawn behind the cage of the dogs, and suddenly he was on this side of the cage. And I think that's fair that Reapers can do that, because the DM is trying to kill you. So, from a lore standpoint, that makes sense. They don't care if it's not unfair. I mean, the unfair is fair. I think that's my opinion. So, some Reaper, about the Reapers, I have some info. So, Fear Reaper are those that give you fear itself, which is the AoE DOT force damage. I think if you're really close to them or really far from them, you don't get it. So you should try it, but I think Fear Reaper work that way. They don't seem to actually cause the fear spell, though. Probably, you know, devs said, well, everyone is immune to fear starting at level 10, so why they should waste time casting fear? Carnage Reaper seems to be more melee-oriented. I saw them actually go for me or the others, and not to stand in the back like the other Reapers, which are more casters apparently. Plague Reaper seems to give some kind of debuff, which I wasn't able to see what it was. It looked like a purple hand, the icon I mean, but I didn't last long enough to be able to hover it and see it. And I don't know if there was some other Reaper, Canner, Fear, Flag. I think there was a fourth one. Yeah, there should be a fourth one. I haven't found it probably yet. Also, let's end with some suggestions. My suggestion is bring hirelings and summons. What? You might say. Are you joking? Well, I'm not. That's pretty strange, maybe. But true. You know, apparently, that might be a bug. Summons do get at least in a part of the Reaper scaling effect. Maybe not of the summons, but they lasted really longer than they should have been compared to Elite. They lasted longer than Elite. So, that's my guess. For sure, any extra body helps, because they, of course if you are soloing this, because they take aggro. And they have hit points. They will take maybe 30 seconds to die. Well, in those 30 seconds, you kill the Reaper or you kill the champion. And that's what is scary. Regular mob are just regular mob. They do hit a little harder, you do a little less damage, but on Reaper 1, it's not that big of a penalty or bonus. The problem are champions and Reapers, and if you're smart enough, they won't hit you, because they will be hitting your extra bodies. As you see on my video here, I had the artificial dog, I had a regular hireling, and I have the level 3 permanent hireling. And also, I had, well, of course, when I cast the spell, I had also the flame to rack, which tends to sustain more hits than I thought. And all those extra aggro magnet helped. Their damage was subpar, but enough to distract them from you. Also, if you bring an Eveling, or more than one, bring an healer, bring an healer, or, as in my case, for low levels, bring two healers, one being permanent, level 3, and another, maybe a Fire of the Soul, because spell points are tight and they can't get the magic gems. Sadly, I tried it. Evelings can't get the magic gems. So they can heal each other instead of heal themselves, which they can't. Also, if Warforged, consider take healer's friend even if you are not efficient. I didn't plan to do that, but it's necessary. I can see my healing isn't enough. And hirelings have trouble to heal me. Also, if you are soloing magic gems, actually keep you heal with SP. I mean, in the depths, those are 40. Yeah, 40 spell points each gem. And my spells cost maybe 2 to 6 spell points, so wasn't really an issue the spell point cost at low levels. Probably higher levels will be different, also because I won't be carrying my level 3 Eveling much longer. She won't be useful next level, probably, so I will have to find another way, but if you are in a group, that's better. Reaper is supposed to be a good thing, so pass the elephant, put the elephant up, and in 2 or 3 of you, you can pull it. Extra about this is what you need, not anything else. So far, what's my judgment on Reaper? Well, I give them an 8 out of 10. That was a good implementation. I probably don't like the Reaper trees, the existence of the Reaper trees, but whatever. Reaper 1 is fine, Reaper 1 might be the new Elite for some players. at least for the oldest quest, I don't see in heroics temporal elemental evil being doing on Reaper, not at all. But for other quests, I mean for the depths, or I don't know, all the quests up to this level, except maybe Puppies the Poison or Caverns of Kogomar, those of course not every group will doing that on Reaper 1, but for regular questing, sure, why not? But still, it's challenging. You see, I had close call. I didn't have any close call till Reaper came out. Didn't have close call on Elites at level till now. I mean, I had a close call on Reaper 3 Bringing the Light, one of the easiest quests in the game. At level 7 I had a close call. It's funny, it's fun. And I'm only a 4th lifer with 6 epic past lives. Not many. I really don't have many past lives. Oh, no, wait. I have only 5 epic past lives. I was wrong. So, I mean, for all longest player, Reaper 1 might even be not easy, but significantly easier than it is to me. But yet, again, they can do Reaper 2. You add all the difficulty you want, and trust me, you won't solo more than Reaper 2, maybe 3 right now in heroics. And I hope neither in epics. So, it brought us that's what we wanted. Really, exactly what we wanted. Alright, enough of bubbling about, and well, for Tower of Frost, I haven't played on the regular server. I have my Lamania previews, and that quest is probably a 7 out of 10 as judgment. Not gonna talk about it right now, probably will when I do that quest on my regular series. And that's all, I think. Oh no, the Reaper XP. All the quests I did, I mean Reaper 1 and 3 Bringing the Light, Reaper 1 Depths of Doom, Reaper 1 Depths of Discord, and Reaper 1 Chamber of Insanity, give me like half the XP you need for the first Reaper enhancement point, the first action point for the Reaper enhancement. So it's a pretty long grind, I think, assuming that it's not linear but exponential, as or at least, I mean, not linear. That's long, a long grind, but it's not like a grind you have to get to be able to do Reaper. You start doing Reaper, lower Reaper, when you get to the Tier 5 enhancements, you still won't be able to do Reaper then. You will do maybe instead of Reaper 1, Reaper 2, maybe 3. But yet again, those announcements are not all working right away. They have a level requirement to be applied to you. So still, it's... And with levels, Reaper will become more difficult, especially for new quests. I mean, at level 16, maybe Acid Wit won't be that difficult to do, but all the other quests, all the other quests which are newer, will be. So, it's not that a grind you need to be able to complete, and also, it's not a grind that will make you complete either. If you have all the trees filled out, yes, it will be slightly easier than now, but it won't ever be that Reaper 2 is the new elite. Never. Reaper 1 probably will be easier than elite once you have all the trees filled out, because you will have enough goodies to tone down the bonus and malus you get from being in Reaper, and so the difficulty will be close to elite, even on Apex probably, maybe even a little less than Epic Elite. But Reaper 2, not talk about Reaper 3, no way, won't be the new elite. I mean, there might be people who will complete it, but those are the people that can go around blinded on Epic Elites, complete Legendary Elite Shroud without a sweat, and so on. There are some of them. So, Reaper was much needed, and they did it right. I was on the forums, I criticized the lockdown, but after they relaxed it to plus 6 over the quest level, I said, yes, you made it. That's the right thing to do, and boy, I'm sure about it. I played it. It is right. Good job, Standing Stone. Alright, thanks for watching, please subscribe, and see you later.